glad the Leafs won, but man, that's just a tough season for New Jersey, you know? I thought they'd be better. You want to talk about someone having a rough season in the Metro? Take a look at what happened in the Flyers game. How bad could it have? Whoa!
Let's go!
Good. We all feel
stop!
Good.
Stop!
Never gets rusty!
What am I doing?
Get in my kitchen! Producer Drew, can you fix all this?
And when it comes to the Toronto Maple Leafs, you can crumple, crumple, yeet! Saw that going differently.
With you, wherever you are, welcome to LFR.
Puppies! Listen. We need you to settle this once and for all. We don't know how many more games he's going to play. If this goes in, he's getting 70. This is it. Oh, let's go!
Yeah!
At least you're not the Flyers? Question mark? Leafs win! 5-2 over the New Jersey Devils! Credit where credit's due before we even talk about the game. Gosh darn it. If it weren't for Jake Allen, this game and in the last one that the Leafs played against the Devils, Austin Matthews might already be at 70. Like, dude, please don't start him Thursday. Get someone else out there. Give him a shot. Oh, it's ridiculous and annoying. Let's talk about that game. So one of the questions that keeps popping up, you guys ask it whenever I ask for questions for the LFR. We talk about it on the podcast. Is Sheldon Keefe going to rest some guys? He sort of did in this one. Mostly guys around the periphery of the lineup. Labushkin getting a rest. He's not exactly in the periphery. Reeves getting a rest. Dewar getting a rest. Nick Robertson in the lineup. And that's interesting. I'll tell you why later. Noah Gregor also in the lineup. Connor Timmins. Giordano getting a look. Obviously Liljegren not back yet. Samsonov getting the night off entirely. Wohl was the starter. Jones is the backup. I still think Jones is going to play games this week. I just do. There's no point risking one of Wohl or Samsonov. So, will any of the guys who got into the lineup, honestly, could be playing their last game of the season? They're probably not, but could be. How do they do? Well, first and foremost, I know Sheldon Keefe and Nick Robertson and a lot of people think that Keefe doesn't like him at all. Dude, he put him in a really good position in this game, and it led to two lines doing really well. Nick Robertson got put on the third line with Holmberg and Nylander. That's a great opportunity for the kid. Matthew Nyes demoted to the fourth line. He was spectacular in this game outside of one bad penalty. First goal. What did I say yesterday? Matthew Nyes, he scored a goal. Who got the assist that wasn't really an assist? Pontus Holmberg, making a mess of things in front of the net. Well, what happens on this one? Puck is in the slot, there's a scramble for it, Nick Robertson is first to it, and he has the snipe, but it's Pontus Holmberg being a jerk in front of the net. A lot of people talk about the Devils taking a step backward. I mean, they got Jake Allen. They're also gonna get Dougie Hamilton. It's gonna be like, imagine your team trading for Dougie Hamilton. That's what it's going to be like for the New Jersey Devils next season. They basically didn't have him. He was healthy for, what, a month? Simon Nemec had Holmberg down against the boards, and he shoved him, and I'm mean. And Holmberg just sort of got up because Nemec let up. Then Holmberg parked himself in the slot. No Devil touched him. Dude, I like a lot of parts of their team. They're so soft, though. And Robertson with the snipe. It's amazing, though, Robertson and Nyes having an easier time scoring goals on back-to-back nights because of what Holmberg did. I really, 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 I have a hard time envisioning this lineup without him in it in the playoffs. I do. Could you imagine Dewar comes out and it's Nyes who drops down to the fourth line and they keep Robertson on the third? That's probably not what they do, but the dude has 13 goals. He's on a 20-goal pace. Adam Wilde always talks about this on the podcast. Nick Robertson will score 20 goals next season. I'm starting to buy into that propaganda. Do not trade him. Please re-sign him for as long as possible. This guy is a Leaf. He will be a regular next season. Everyone calm down. No matter what happens these playoffs, Nick Robertson could and should be a Leafs next season. What happened to my mouth? Could and should be a Leaf next season. Then the game goes a little squirrely, and I want to talk about a couple things, like, just before the narrative gets out of hand. The Devils scored two goals. Number one, the Nico Hischier goal. Damn. That's just a really good goal.
I know I said that yesterday about the Raquel goal. Like, come on, Steve, hammer him. Like, eh.
We see the Leafs do stuff like that all the time. Like, they'll split the D or they'll send a long pass. And we're just like, yeah, Mitch or Willie, who are usually on the receiving end of those. Long pass, they get it. Willie probably didn't even look at the thing when receiving it in his stick. And then they snipe. Could Benoit and McCabe have played this better? Yeah, they got scored on. But it's a sick pass from Dawson Mercer, who's good at that, to Nico Hischier, who scores, who's good at that. Speaking of guys the Devils are going to reacquire next year, I know Mercer got his 20th of the season. That's only his 13th assist. He's just a better player than that. Like, I'm so surprised by a bunch of the performances on the Devils this year. And no Jack Hughes in this game. You gotta win, boys. Well, early in the second period, Leafs take a penalty, and to the power play, the Devils go. And this is where the argument for Connor Dewar staying in the lineup is strongest, because the Leafs' penalty kill has been great. It's been much improved since he has joined, and then they get scored on. You might look at the shot count at this time. Jake Allen making a whole bunch of saves. The Leafs are way out shooting the Devils. Joseph Woll has had a quiet night, and oh, the Leafs are down 2-1, and darn it, Joseph Woll has not been good. I'm a little surprised Joseph Woll hasn't been better, but this game ain't it. Dude, look at this. Look at this. I know it's on the penalty kill, but that is a human being in Dawson Mercer just getting to do whatever he wants because no one's there. I know it's a penalty kill, but oof and also yuck, 2-1 Devils. So what happens after that? Jake Allen continues to stone the Leafs, and not just the Leafs, but Austin Matthews, who had a partial break. And the Leafs picked up 2 goals in, on the broadcast, they said 14 seconds. On NHL.com, it says 9. They got 2 goals in 9 seconds. The first one especially is my favorite because I don't know when the moment was that they talked about this on the bench, but this had to have been a set play. Max Domi charging in. He's got the puck. Tyler Bertuzzi on the other side. Mark Giordano charging the slot for some reason, and Matthews pulls up and peels. And this is the effect that that had on the Devils' defense. What the, what is going on? What? You can't even blame the Devils because, okay, which one of these guys is about to drive the net in this situation? The greatest goal scorer in the NHL, the guy with more goals than anyone else in the salary cap era, or a man who has literally been the oldest active player in the NHL for over a calendar year? If you bet on Matthews there, you'd lose. Because it's Gio who crashes Matthews, it just opens up this huge lane. You could drive a bus through it to Tyler Bertuzzi. Max Domi with his 35th assist of the season. Bertuzzi with his 20th goal. And the Leafs tie it up. 9 seconds later, Bertuzzi and Matthews picking up assists by just sending it to Gio, who yeets the thing on net, and that one beats Jake Allen. Well, how did that one beat Jake Allen? He's been so good. Can I show you a screenshot? It's a really incredible screenshot, and I watched the footage leading up to the screenshot, and even I looked at the screenshot and went, did I get the right moment? All right, what do we got? We got, I think that's Jake McCabe, or it's another Leaf defenseman. He's on the left side of the point. Giordano, he's winding up. He's about to clap bomb this puck. There's a Devil in the high slot. There's Nico Hischier there, sort of at the edge of the faceoff dot. There's Ball there. There's some other guys next to the boards. And obviously, Jake Allen is in net. And Jake Allen is holding 2 hockey sticks. Oh, there's a Leaf there. There's a Leaf in front of Jake Allen there. Dude, it's incredible. If you don't see the hockey stick that Max Domi is holding in his hand, you would otherwise only be able to see a few pixels of him. It's such an effective screen from Domi, and I think that's what Giordano was pointing at after the goal when he was praising all his teammates. I do think a Devil eventually got in front of Jake Allen, but because of this screen from Domi, this just flyby, I don't think Allen picked up the puck when it left Giordano's stick. That makes it 3-2, and that is the eventual game winner, but it's not the main event, is it? Dude, this goal, shows why the Bertuzzi-Matthews-Domi line has to stay together, at least to start the playoffs. Dude, these guys cracked the code. They figured it out. It's not just that Matthews has been hot, and he's been hot, but everyone is pulling their weight, and they have different crafty ways of scoring. What were the Devils doing earlier in the game? They were zeroing in on Matthews, and they had him stymied every time, and the few times he did break through, Jake Allen was able to stop him. What did the Leafs do? They changed it up. They changed it up, and they got some scoring chances that led to goals, spread it out, do something a little different, have Geo go in there, and now Bertuzzi's open, and Domi can find him because he's an elite playmaker, and he finds him, and Bertuzzi's able to bang it in. Don't have a great chance, like, don't have a great shot, we'll turn it into a great shot by putting on a great screen. There's Max Domi again, earning his spot on that top line. And on this goal, Max Domi earns his keep by setting up Austin Matthews, passing it to him, which honestly, I'm not entirely convinced that there aren't people watching this video right now who couldn't set up Austin Matthews for a goal. But the reason I walked you through those two goals and how they find offense through other roads other than the Matthews road, the reason I point that out, look at this! Look at this! The New Jersey Devils were all over Matthews, all over him, because they knew the Leafs were looking for him. The Leafs changed it up. They got them thinking, and look at him. He's a ghost. The greatest active goal-scoring season, literally, in the National Hockey League. He's a ghost. He's a ghost. They don't know he's there. And then he's able to fire some shot that any other player in the league would get yelled at for because it looks lazy and would probably miss 4 or 5 feet high. And it's golden. His 66th goal of the season. It's a new Leaf record. Every goal he scores for the rest of the season is a new Leaf record. And now, every goal for the rest of the season that Matthews scores will be the new salary cap era record. Do you understand? Do you understand? Alexander Ovechkin got his 30th goal of the season tonight. Probably next season, if he keeps this up, he's going to break Gretzky's record. And if he doesn't break Gretzky's record next season, he'll do it the season after, probably pretty early on. And that man, that goal-scoring machine, never scored 66 goals in a season. It's unbelievable what Matthews is doing. Unbelievable. He has 364 career goals. The guy is 26. It's staggering. It's absolutely staggering. He's got 104 points. Only 38 of them are assists. I love Matthew's stats because how do you read them and not laugh? Anyway, Bertuzzi gets the empty netter. Hooray. Wool, after that goal from Dawson Mercer, where Mercer was left completely alone, didn't allow another goal. Had a decently awesome game. And this is, just because Matthew's page is open on my phone, he actually has a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 game goal streak. And none of us noticed because it's him. It's him. He's him. It, like, you would look at that and go, wow, that guy, oh, it's him. You're like, oh, wow, what an alien. Like, you look at him. He's him. Oh, questions. Isn't this the question? Does Poppy actually get to 70? How realistic of a hope is it now? All right, here's what it is. All right, they got 4 games left. 4. That's it. 2 at home, 2 on the road. Thursday at home against New Jersey. I'm just saying, hit him with the 4 to hit 70 at home. Poetic. That's cinema. That's good stuff. But, okay, the Devils at home on Thursday. Saturday, Detroit Red Wings. Might be a tougher game. Detroit's fighting tooth and nail to get into the playoffs. And the Flyers decided they're not interested. They're fighting tooth and nail. Then, to back-to-back in Florida, Panthers, Lightning. There's a solid chance. There's a really, really, really almost guaranteed chance Matthews doesn't play that final game. There's a greater than zero chance that Matthews doesn't play either of those games. I mean, what for? Does he hit 70? It's possible. It's way more than possible. Matthews getting 4 goals in 2 games? We've seen him do that a ton of times. A whole bunch of times. Is it realistic? No, it's not. But It's him.
This isn't a question, it's just a stat from Luke Fox, and it's a good one. Toronto Maple Leafs, 24 road wins is a franchise record. Two more road games to go. Thought I'd throw that out there because a lot of people have been asking about road or home ice advantage. Good boy Iggy deserves 66 treats tonight. Well, he might agree, but he's 9 years old and that might kill him. Like, he's in really good shape. Like, I'm not worried about that, but that might kill him. For the Leafs' best option, do you want to eventually go through the Bruins? Yes, they have to earn it, but would you rather them in a round just to finally get that monkey off the back? Not looking past the Panthers, as that's the likely opponent. I mean, poetically and dramatically and cinematically, the Leafs beating the Bruins en route to a rather magical playoff run. Yeah, that would be the best. I always think about the Washington Capitals 2018. They finally beat Crosby and the Penguins, and then they went on to do the thing. It's the playoffs. It's hard no matter what. You don't get to pick your path. The Leafs got to take on the Montreal Canadiens 2021. Probably anyone would have taken that matchup on account of they were not a good team. And then the Leafs blew it, and then the Habs made it all the way to the final. So maybe they were actually good, despite the fact that they were down 3-1 in the first round to a team that won their division. And wait a sec, am I describing the Habs or Panthers? If there's anything the past few years should have taught us, it's don't worry so much about the matchup. Anyone can do it. So what I want for the Leafs, I want them to get through round one. And I want them to get through round two after that, and then round three, and then round four. But since round one is the only one in front of us, I want them to get through round one. Last but not least, from El Seldo, when Torts retires, you gonna get him his own podcast? See, that's interesting. That's very interesting. So the closest comparable to that would probably be Agent Provocateur with Adam Walsh. Alan Walsh is the primary talker of that show, and Adam asks Alan questions, and he sets him up, and Alan knocks him down. That's the dynamic there. I don't think Torts could do a podcast like that. I don't think he could. We've seen him on panel shows before. It wasn't good. He was on TSN, like, years ago. It wasn't good. He's a great coach press conference giver. He's not, in a studio setting all that entertaining. Honestly, I think the only way a Torts podcast could work is if you don't give him a co-host and you just make him do it Bill Burr podcast style. I see, you know what, dude? And he's just sitting there rambling, like, out of his windshield. Like, whatever, wherever he chooses to record the show, it's just John Tortorella riffing. Just talking. Mad disrespect and ridiculousness. And he maybe has someone who every now and then just says a topic, the defense, or something like that, but you can't hear them, only he can hear them, and he just riffs, and he gives them crap, and he yells at them. That's, I think, a ramble. I want a John Tortorella ramble. You couldn't have a coast. Wouldn't work. We're on to something here. I'm kind of good at this. So, that is it for this one. Thank you very much for watching. Click like if you liked this video. Click subscribe if you really liked it. Tell all your friends. It's four away from 70. Could and should be a Leafs next... What happened to my mouth?